Hey, what's going on, everybody? We are finally back with another Sonic Prime trailer reaction, and I'm so excited. This year cannot get any better for the Blue Rat, and oh my god, Frontiers was so good. So good. There will be some sort of like weird review, thank you video coming out soon. I've just finished scripting the video, so onto the editing phase. So it won't be out in like next couple of days, but stay tuned. But now the sort of look for the franchise now shifts onto Sonic Prime. That is the next biggest thing to come throughout the franchise, and I'm really looking forward to it. Out of all the trailers we've seen so far, this looks like it will be a ton of fun, and it is really well made. I had no idea there was another trailer coming out today, but here we are, there is another one. And I'm excited. I think this is the obviously the second main trailer that we have gotten, so let's get into it. 3, 2, 1.
Hello, I'm Sonic.
Hello. Oh my god, he looks so cool.
You've got a crew like mine?
Whoa! Okay, first look of Amy.
There's nothing that can stop you.
Oh my god, the squash and stretch.
Just in time to watch me claim the
pair. Are those all button keyboard?
Yawn. Yep, I yawned you, Eggman.
Crush them all!
I love the classic Badnik designs here. It's so cool. Good old Egg Dragoon. Oh, Knuckles sounded cool from that. Ooh, this looks so good. The animation.
Sonic, where are you?
Okay. Face first. Damn it, no.
Where am I?
Huh? Imagine the trailer just cut there.
Another world.
Whoa, he looks so good.
My shoes. Looks like an Eggman family reunion.
We are the council.
We finally got the first look at them. They look so good.
You're all new yous.
Okay, that's a new area.
They don't know who I am. More worlds.
Whoa, their designs look so cool. Tails sounds good.
Pirates.
There's awesome. A pirate.
If we lose this fight, there won't be anything left to fight for.
So we're gonna face
it. So it does look like maybe it's a new world every week, maybe? Oh, this music. This looks really good.
Enough running.
So there are like Mobians here as well, which looks cool. They got the characterization down to a T. Oh, okay then. So here's what I'm thinking from that shadow thing, is that the spotlight is going to be mainly on Sonic, obviously, because it is Sonic Prime, and obviously they have been thrown into the different multiverses and everything. But I feel like because Shadow can use Chaos Control and he has gone through time and space by using that, maybe he is able to find Sonic through that, or something to do with the Chaos Emeralds. That would be kind of cool. And the fact that if that is the case and they're leaning into that is sick. I love this. This whole, like, the whole gang here looks brilliant. I love that. It's a pink Flicky. That looks weird, but cool at the same time. It's an inverted Flicky. I've never seen that before. Yeah, I don't know how to feel about that, but Pig's there, Froggy, got Tails and Knuckles, they all look brilliant. Like, oh my god, this is gonna be a good show. Like, the writing already seems pretty good. Like, they've got the characterization down really well, I will say that. They always have. I love the classic Badniks that are here, mixed with, obviously, Orbot and Cubot. They were in the other trailer, but I'd never mentioned it. But this is really cool. I like seeing modernizations of classic designs. It's really cool. So we saw like Buzz Bombers with the bound to be Moto Bugs. Like, that is really cool. I love the yawn. It's very sort of I don't say meta era, but of that era, but it works here because it is a TV show. It's going for definitely boom, but more in that boom writing, I think, but more action oriented and more Sonic like. Whereas Boom to me was a good TV show and had good moments and character, like the characters were fine, but they weren't the game characters, if you understand me. I think this is a good mix between what Boom the TV show did and the normal modern cast. I think this is going to be really cool. I love the effects here, the chromatic apparition. I want to say that's probably the wrong word, but I love just all the colors. It looks really good. And we just hear Tails go, "Sonic, where are you?" He falls. So this is obviously, I think this is bound to be the first place he's going to, which is really cool. This whole place looks really depressing, really like mute. The color palette's very muted. You obviously got like the little bits of yellow and pinks here and there, but the main color is dark greens, olives, and like grays, which I think fits the mood really well. Obviously you see all the characters here that are depressed. They're very upset because who, of course you would be if you're under Eggman rule. He gets hit by a truck, which is funny. I love Rouge's outfit. I think she looks cool in this universe. I know some people, that's been like quite a controversial thing, like people are saying her design here isn't that good for this world, but I like it. I think it's really cool. We got this universe's, do you know what these kind of remind me of? They kind of reminded me of the bots, I don't want to call them badniks, but from Sonic 06, like the main enemy you would defeat. It kind of gives me off that vibe, but they look cool. That shot is such a, that's in terms of emotion and characteristics, just from one shot, that is Marza level of like quality. That is a really good Sonic shot. That is really cool. And I as soon as I saw that, I knew that this is probably going to be part of the thumbnail. If not, I probably found something maybe a tad bit better or would be more on point for this. But I love that this pose, his emotion is really cool in this. This is squash and stretch in general is really cool. So what, maybe the whole reason he got a new gloves and shoes is because maybe they're from the other dimension and maybe they're getting like torn up and turned to shreds by him running in this dimension. I don't know how that works, but it's cool. What? Oh my god, hold on. Is that okay? I love this. I didn't realize this before, but I think what they're doing with the different bots for this dimension, or with like they call themselves the council, is that each Eggman obviously has their own mech to use, but they're all characterized to themselves. So you've got like the teenage one in the top left has flames and it flies, and you got like the speak and say egg like mech thing on the right hand side, probably for the baby, and then you got like the really, I don't say buff, but it's definitely like very strong looking bot in the middle, and that's probably just for like regular Eggman. But that is really cool. They have their own specific thing. It really reminds me of how Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog worked. It really harkens back to that sort of style, and I love that so much. Okay, we actually get a properly good look at the council. And I think these designs are so cool. So obviously you got on the left, you got the baby. So I just realized that only the baby and the elder one actually have the classic circular goggles. I kind of like that. Then next up you got like the emo, the angsty like teen. You got the colored like dyed hair at the front. He's got like cut off shades. He's on his tablet like that. That is perfect. You got like normal Eggman, yeah, in terms of age. So that would be this multiverse's Eggman with a really weird haircut, I will say. It looks like part of it has been just sort of shaven off in the middle. But I love his design. All of these reek of like Eggman, but they've just been tweaked, and I think that is perfect. Then you have, I don't even know what this next one is, but he's got some black shoes on and a pretty fancy mustache. And then you got the Elder Eggman on the right hand side, who is very tiny, which I like. He has the classic walker with the tennis balls on the bottom, and he has an amazing beard as well, I must say. But I love all these character designs. The thing I like about this is that, yes, they're making new characters and they're making new designs for pre-established characters, but this wouldn't look out of the norm if it was in the game universe, you know? And I like that, because obviously that is what the Sonic team is trying to do with this series, is make it so they stylistically all sort of fit into one universe, which I think is great. Animation-wise, it is so good. Let's go back. I just want to see him talk. Look at this, the amount of bounce. Oh, yeah, he has purple goggles on. That's kind of cool. But I love the amount of bounce he has in his... Look at his mustache as well. Oh, is that a toupee? I think it might be a toupee. Oh my god, it 100% is. He is having a midlife crisis. Oh my god, that is absolutely amazing. I didn't realize. Oh my god. Tails looks awesome, Amy. We've all seen this before. This is the big thing. Which, I love Amy's design here. But another thing I just realized. This Flicky has been brought across as well, in terms of maybe they have like their own little friends or whatever, like animal friends like Amy might have. And in this universe, instead of a Flicky, it's a giant bird, but the color scheme is exactly the same. Maybe that's another thing that transfers across, we don't know. But the design here is so cool. Look at Big. They actually kind of made Big look menacing for once, which is crazy. So in that universe, he says they don't know who he is. So that kind of implies that in the main universe we've seen already, the Eggman 1 universe, the city, they probably recognize him there. That's what it tells me. But this looks so good. Hold on. I think he gets new shoes per universe. Yeah, look, he gets new shoes and gloves per universe. So Sonic Generations modders are going to have so much fun with this. And just Sonic modders in general, because we get more custom items, which is so cool. These all look great. And we got Pirate Island as well. He gets new gloves. He gets completely new gloves and shoes. Yes, he gets new shoes, but you can't really have a good look at them. But that's cool. Knuckles looks so good here. Of course, he's the captain. And then, okay, so it looks like they were maybe experimenting on the crystal. I already forgotten what the name of it is. And maybe that sucked him into a new dimension. And that's how the first episode ends. I don't know. But this is really cool. The animation is so good. I love this. I'm so excited. I'm literally getting a Netflix account for this. I can't... Like, this shot here is so cool. This shows me they're getting the characterization of these characters really, like, down proper. Like, so good. So, to me, he is running here with... That's either a completely different universe, or that's the gloves we saw in the pirate universe. But he's running through cyberspace here. He's running through the multi-dimensions here. And I love the figure eight that they're using. It looks so good. But the fact that it's changing colors because that's what the lighting is here is so, so cool looking. And then there's Shadow. And here's the full animation for the logo. it breaks and shatters, and that's it. I am so excited for this. You have no idea. I know my voice probably doesn't say that very well, but I am so excited for this, and I would love to hear what you guys think about this in the comment section down below, because my god, we have had such a good year for this series, and with the DLC announcements that there's going to be more for Frontiers, I don't think that's going to stop anytime soon. And hopefully Sonic Prime gets multiple seasons and Netflix doesn't pull the plug like it has done with many others of its animation series. One can hope that it can stay on there as long as it needs to stay on there. But with all of that out of the way, thank you so much for watching. I will see you all in the next video. Take care.